Congratulations, Tim Bradley. Yesterday at the weigh-in, Jesse Vargas, he said he was stronger than you and he had more will than you. How satisfying is this victory and how strong was he? Who had more willpower?
Me. I had more willpower. He landed that shot at the end, but I felt like I said, I was controlling him, mowing him down, controlling the action, especially in the second half of the fight. He started coming down and I just kept pointing on him, man. Kept pointing on him, landing right hands over the top, trying to land a hook over the top. My jab was working really well at times. But, you know, he's a strong fighter. I tip my hat off to Jesse. He was a lot tougher than I expected. He came to fight. Really good young talent. I mean, he has nothing to be ashamed of. He fought against one of the best pound for pounds in the game. I feel like I'm 100% one of the best pound for pound fighters in the world. I don't care how you guys rate me, but I feel I am. 5 world championships. I mean, that speaks for itself. Look at my resume. I fight none but the best. I keep fighting dog after dog after dog after dog. I'm sure my next fight's gonna be against another dog. And I don't get it easy. I don't get hand-picked fights. You know, these guys, they put them in front of me, top rank put them in front of me, and I just keep taking them down.
Timothy, when Jesse was in here, he said that you called him a great champion.
Yeah.
He thought that meant that you thought that you had lost the fight. Were you referring to him as a great champion because he won 40 titles?
I said he's a great champion. I said there's nothing to be ashamed of. You're champion at 140. You can go back down to 140 and remain and reign at 140. And be a champion. He took that the wrong way. I was commenting him, giving him a compliment because he fought a good fight.
Tim, congratulations on completing your Christmas picture.
Yes, it out, man. My son gonna love that thing, man. Hey, this thing got little jewels on it, man. It's nice. Diamonds on it. It's tight. Yeah, it's tight, man. Hey, I want to thank the WBO, man, for believing in me, man, and giving me a shot. This is my first vacant world championship. Normally I have to fight the champion to get it, but it feels awesome to get this vacant world championship. So it's beautiful, man.
Tim, let me ask you, what round did you notice in addition to his will, but his stamina was diminishing?
My trainer was telling me after 4, he's like, after 4, this kid's gonna fade, Tim. He's like, you can't get ready in a month for you. He said he's gonna fade, and he said he's fading. You can go back and look at the film, listen in on our corner, and you'll hear my trainer say he's getting tired, Tim. He's getting tired. Keep going down, keep on it down. And my trainer wanted me to keep my hands high and walk him down and bang him to the body. But like as I got closer, we would clinch up, and it was really hard to land really good body shots on him. But I landed a few. I felt I hurt him to the body. I think I hurt him to the head. I don't know if anybody asked him, did I hurt him? But I think I heard him a couple of times, twice, in the fight.
Tim, the last time you had that belt, it was under heavy scrutiny and controversy, and you brought it back to the Coachella Valley and received death threats for that. Obviously, this is going to be a little bit different for you. Can you just talk about coming back to the Coachella Valley, what you mean to the community, and now bringing a world title back like you wanted to?
Well, the Coachella Valley got my back, and I got the Coachella Valley back, and, you know, I fight for all the people from my city where I'm from, my area from where I'm from. I just want to be an inspiration to all the kids, the youth, anybody, even the parents out there. And it means a lot, man, bringing this back. Because I promised everybody, I was like, I'm going to bring it back. I'm going to bring the championship back to the dirty desert, like where it belongs, because I lost this belt to Manny Pacquiao. And I knew I would get it back sooner or later, but didn't know when. And you know, opportunity presented itself. Paco gave me an opportunity to fight for the championship against Jesse Vargas. So it's sweet, man. I love it. It sucks that I can't get a win and enjoy it without any kind of scrutiny. But I figure that's my career path. It's the way God wanted it to be. And I guess he wants me to be a testament to all the fighters or anybody that's going through a lot of scrutiny in their career or life or I don't know. But it sucks, but I've been here before, guys. It's nothing to me. People say whatever they want to say. They may say whatever they want to say. But clearly, watching the social media, everybody's saying that, Tim, hold your head up. You with that butt.
Say someone tough next again. You always fight tough fights. Who do you want? Who do you see?
I never call out anybody because it's dumb to call guys out. like I tell you, I just fight. I'll fight the best, anybody. I never call out anybody. I'm serious. The top welterweights in the division, or even go to junior middleweight. I wouldn't mind trying that way too. I know everybody think I'm crazy, but I don't care. I really don't care what anybody think. I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna do what I do. And everybody think I'm crazy calling out Golovkin and, you know, Triple G or whatever, but I don't care. I'll fight anybody.
So you want that fight next, maybe?
Good, man. If my team won it, I'll do it. But, you know, I'll make that the ultimate decision. I'm crazy. So, like I said, I called out Klitschko, too. I was like, I'll fight Klitschko. I think I'd go more than six rounds with him. I just got to avoid that right hand and just move all night. Don't stand in one spot, you know. But, you know, that's not the case. I got a team of people that work around me and that control my career, my wife, and she works hand in hand with Top Rank and my trainer and everybody on the team, and they put together the fights for me. I don't care. I just say line them up.
Bradley, before each fight, a member of the opposing team goes into the dressing room with the other fighter and watches the hands get wrapped. Who wrapped Jesse's hands?
What's that guy name?
Rafael.
Garcia.
It wasn't Rafael.
No, Rafael didn't mark?
The other guy that was there.
His cut man.
Oh, it was another cut man.
I don't know.
I wasn't in the room, so I don't know who wrapped his hands.
Because a lot of emphasis was put on that his right hand was numb, I guess due to the wrapping or the glove.
Oh, well, that sucks. yeah, that sucks, man.
That was his fault because he kept asking, do you want it tighter and tighter?
I don't know. My trainer, Joel Diaz, wraps my hands all the time. He does a great job every time, so I don't know. But, hey, I take none away from Jesse. He's a great fighter, great young talent. He's going to bounce back. He's tough for anybody in the division. He's at 140. He's still the champion. He has nothing. He can hold his head up high. He fought a great fight. He hurt me at the end of the fight. You know, even with 9 knockouts, I was like, what the heck? That was a big right hand, man. And he landed right on the button, but I bounced back, man. Great, phenomenal shape. My team, everybody got me. My strength and conditioning trainer, Mr. Roosley, Frank, everybody, they got me in tremendous shape. My coach worked me so hard for this fight. I was like, man, why are you working me so hard, man? And every now and then I would swear at him. I would say, F you, coach, because he would kill me in the gym, man. And now I understand why. And I just want to thank my whole team up here. Thank you guys so much for doing what you do, man, and pushing me in the gym. And that's the reason why we passed my fifth year coming too. Hey, thank you guys for coming out, really. And, real quick, I got a question for y'all. I've been hearing, was it a good fight?
It was a great fight.
Yeah.
So people saying that he was like, oh, fight of the year, but with that controversy, you don't know. Was it a good fight? Was it a fight of the year category?
It was very good over the first half, and then slowed down until it was on 12
o'clock. Okay, all right, cool.
It was a great fight.
Thank you.
Now, you took control after six.
Thank you, guys.
Tim, everyone's a critic. It was a great fight.
Thank you.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Sekpak.